Hello children, good morning all of you. I am G. Kavita, school assistant maths at ZPHS Tirumalaipalam, Khammam district. Children, today we are going to learn about your second chapter, polynomials and factorization. Today is the day one class. In this class we will learn about polynomials. Dear children, before going to learn about polynomials, we will recall some terms like constants, variables and expressions. You all know all these terms, children. Once we will recall, what are constants? Constant means it has a fixed value. That means its value will not be changed anywhere. For example, the numbers which we are using in our daily life. And etc. are constants. Next, variables. Variables means its value varies. Varies means changes. That means variables has no fixed value. It will change according to the situation or problem. For example, height of the tree. The tree height changes day by day. And also your age. It's also changes according to every year your age is also changing. And we denote these variables with English alphabets. X, Y, Z, A, B, C, R, T, etc. All the English alphabets can be denoted as variables. And also next, we observe children, years are changing. Last year is 2019 and this year is 2020 and next year is 2021. Like that, years are changing. But what about the months in the years? Months January, February, March up to December are not changing. In every year, they have only 12 months, January to December. Therefore, months are constants and years are variables. Also, number of days in the months. In January, we have 31 days in every year. And like that, all the days in every month, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December, every month has fixed days. But what about February? Is it has fixed days, children? No. It has 28 days and in leap year it has 29 days. Therefore, number of days in February is varying. Therefore, it is considered as variable. Okay, children? Next, expressions. What are expressions? Expressions means combination of constants and variables by connected by four mathematical operations. What are those? Plus, minus, into and division are called expressions. Combination of constants and variables by plus, minus, into, division are expressions. In those, if we combine only constants, that means 1 plus 2, 12 minus 18, divided by 4, like this. If we have only constants connected by plus minus into division are called numerical expressions. Next, if we have variables and also constants connected by plus minus into division are called algebraical expressions. For example, 2x plus 3y. Here, x and y are variables and 2 and 3 are constants. Like that, constants and variables connected by plus, minus, into and division are called algebraical expressions. Okay, children? I think you have an idea about what are algebraical expressions. Okay. Now, we will see polynomials. What are polynomials? An algebraic expression in which The variables involved having only non-negative integral powers is called polynomials. Algebraic expression, you all know algebraic expression. Just now we recalled it. Combination of constants and variables connected by plus minus into division is algebraic expression. In that algebraic expression, variables having non-negative integral powers. What is non-negative integral? Integral means here integers. What are integers? Children, you know, integers means it has involved 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on, and also negatives minus 2, minus 1, 0, etc. are called integers. 1, 2, 3 are positive integers. Also 0 and minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 are negative integers. Polynomials means in an algebraic expression, for example, if we take 3xy plus 4y square. In this algebraic expression, involved variables x and y having non-negative integral powers. That means powers of variables should be non-negative. Non-negative means that should not be negative. That means that numbers, that powers must not be minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, etc. But they can be 0, 1, 2, 3. That means 0 and positive integers can have the integral, there can have the powers of variables in the algebraic expression. Here, what is the power of x? 1. And y power is 1. So, 1, 1, positive integer. Y square, it is 2. It is also positive integer. Therefore, it is a polynomial. If we take x square plus 2x, x has a power 2. And here x has a power 1. 2 and 1 are also positive integers. Therefore, it is also a polynomial. If we take pi r square, first, is it a polynomial or not? You all know, children, pi, it is a constant. And r square, r is a variable here. And r has a power 2. Therefore, it is also polynomial. 5. Is it a polynomial or not, children? 5 can be written as 5 into x power 0 or 5 into y power 0 or 5 into z power 0, like that. Anything power 0, any variable power 0 is equal to 1. You all know this, children, from your 8th class, you know this. So, 5 can be written as 5 into x power 0. So, the power of variables is how much here? 0. So, 0 can be the power of algebraic variable in the algebraic expression, because it is a polynomial. Okay, children? 5 is also a polynomial. Okay, children, now see this, x power 1 by 2 plus 3, it is a algebraic expression because it has variables and also constants. Okay, now what is the power of variable here? 1 by 2. Is it a integer, children? 1 by 2 is a integer? No, it is not a integer. Therefore, x has not a power of integer, not 0 or positive integer. Therefore, it is not a polynomial. Okay. Next, 2x square minus 3 by x plus 5. In 2x square, it has variable x and power 2. Coming to second term, 3 by x. 3 by x means 3 by x can be written as 3 into x power minus 1. From the exponents, loss of exponents, you know this, children, from your 8th class. 3 by x can be written as 3 into x power minus 1. So, in this algebraic expression, what is the power of variable here? Minus 1. That means it is a negative integer. Therefore, this expression, this algebraic expression is also not a polynomial. Okay, children? Next. Square root of x square plus 4y minus 7. Here, what is the power of variable? X power is 2, but it is under root. So, it can be written as x square. Square root means it can be written as power 1 by 2 plus 4y minus 7. So, x square power 1 by 2 means it is nothing but x. X plus 4y minus 7. So, here x has a power 1, y has a power 1. Therefore, it is also a polynomial. Okay, children? Now, 3 by x plus 1. So, 3 by x plus 1 means x plus 1, x variable is in the denominator. So, if variable is in the denominator, its power can be, if it brings to the numerator, its power will be negative. So, 3 into x plus 1 power minus 1. So, here variable having the power negative numbers. Therefore, it is also not a polynomial. Okay, children? Now, we will see one more example. Root x cube plus 4y minus 7. Square root of x cube. So, this can be written as x cube power square root means 1 by 2 plus 4y minus 7. So, x cube power 1 by 2 means it is x power 3 by 2 plus 4y minus 7. Here, what is the power of variable here? X has a power 3 by 2. 3 by 2 is not a integer. 0 or it is not a positive integer. So, therefore, it is also, it's not a polynomial. Okay, children? Now, I think you are able to do which are polynomials and which are not polynomials. So, that means algebraic expressions having the variables with powers, fractions or negative numbers or if it is in the denominator, that algebraic expressions are not polynomials. Okay, children? Okay, children, now we will see degree of the polynomial. So, what is degree of the polynomial? If we take the polynomial x square, what is the degree of the polynomial? The power of this variable is itself degree. So, x square degree is 2. Okay. If we take 3xy square. How many variables are here, children? Two variables, one is x and second one is y. If we have more than one variable in a polynomial, so what is the degree of that polynomial? That means, here, power of x is 1 and power of y is 2. So, its degree is sum of the powers of these two variables. So, x power 1 and y power 2. Sum of these two variable factors, that is 3. Therefore, the degree of 3xy square is 3. Okay, children? Okay. These two terms have only, these two polynomials have only one term. You see this, children? X square plus 2x plus 5. What is the degree of this polynomial? How many terms we have here? X square is a term, 2x is a term, and 5 is also a term. So, how many terms here? 3 terms are there. So, for this type of polynomials, how have to find the degree of the polynomial? First, you have to find the degree of each and every term. What is the degree of x square here? It is clearly 2. So degree of 2x. What is the power of x here? You all know it should be 1. It is 1. And what is the power of 5? You know children, 5 can be written as any variable power 0. It has a degree 0. So the power of 5 is 0. So these three terms have the degrees 2, 1, 0. Which is the highest in these three? 2 is the highest. Therefore, degree of this polynomial is 2. That means degree of a polynomial is highest degree of the its variable terms. Here 2 is the highest degree, therefore 2 is the degree of total polynomial. Okay children, we will see one more example. 3x cube plus 4x square y cube minus 4y square plus 7. What is the degree of this polynomial? You check children whether it is a polynomial or not. All the variables having only positive integers as a powers. Therefore definitely it is a polynomial. Now check what is the degree. So we have to find the degree of each and every term. What is the degree of this term? 3x cube. Degree is clearly 3. X has a power 3. Therefore its degree is 3. What is the degree of this term? 4x square y cube. Here we have two variables, x and y. Therefore, sum of the powers of these two variable factors is degree. So, what is the power of x here? 2 plus. What is the power of y here? 3. So, 2 plus 3, 5. So, degree of this term is 5. And degree of this term is clearly 2. And degree of this term is, children, it is 0. So, which is the highest in this? 3, 5, 2, 0. Which is the highest one? 5 is the highest one. So, degree of the given polynomial is 5. Okay, children, got it all of you? Now, we will learn about coefficients of the polynomial. What are coefficients? If you take this polynomial x square, coefficient means the number, the constant which we multiply with the variable in the given polynomials. What is here? Is there any constant? No, nothing is there. That means there is 1. So, coefficient of x square is 1. 3xy square. Coefficient of xy square is 3. Coming to this polynomial, x square plus 2x plus 5. Here, coefficient of x square is 1. Coefficient of x is 2. Here, 5 is constant term. 5. Okay, children? You will see some more examples, children. If we have a polynomial 2x cube minus 4x square plus 7 by 2x minus 12. What is the coefficient of x cube? Coefficient of x cube is 2. What is the coefficient of x square? Children, it is not 4. You have to say along with the sign. So, coefficient of x square is minus 4. And coefficient of x is 7 by 2. And what is the constant term here? It is minus 12. Along with the sign, if it has minus, definitely we should say minus. Here we have plus. Need not to say plus. If we didn't say any sign, definitely it is a positive term plus. So, constant is minus 12. Okay, children? One more. Root 3x square plus 4 by 7 root x minus 15. Okay. What is the coefficient of x square? Coefficient of x square is root 3. What is the coefficient of root x? Now here you will get a doubt whether it is a polynomial or not. Since x is in the root, it is under root, that means x power 1 by 2. Therefore it is not a polynomial, but it is a algebraic expression. If they ask the coefficient of root x, you can write it as 4 by 7. If they ask whether it is a polynomial or not, definitely it is not a polynomial. Okay, children? Okay. Okay, children? Now, types of polynomials according to degree. You know, children, if degree is 0. You remember what are those? For every constant, 5 into x power 0, 7 into x power 0, its degree is 0. 5 minus 12 by 17, 2019, etc. Its degree, these all are constants. Therefore, its degree is 0 because these constants can be written as 5 into any variable power 0. Minus 12 by 17 into any variable power 0. So the power of variable is here 0. Therefore degree of this polynomial is 0. If degree of the polynomial is 0, then it is said to be constant polynomial. Degree, type of polynomial, name of the polynomial. Examples. Okay, children. If degree of a polynomial is 1, then it is said to be linear polynomial. If degree of a polynomial is 1, then it is said to be linear polynomial. For example, 2x, 3y, 4x minus 3y plus 7, etc. In every polynomial, we have degree 1. Therefore, these are linear polynomials. If degree of a polynomial is 2, then it is called quadratic polynomial. If degree of a polynomial is 2, then it is called quadratic polynomial. For example, x square, 3y square, 2x square plus 3x minus 5, etc. are quadratic polynomials. If degree of a polynomial is 3, then it is called cubic polynomial. If degree of a polynomial is 3, then it is called cubic polynomial. What will be the examples, children? Can you guess? Any variable term with power 3, x cube. Or 4 by 7 x cube minus 7 y cube, 3 x cube plus 4 x square y minus 5 y cube. It has 3 terms. In every term, degree is 3. Therefore, the degree of this polynomial is 3. Therefore, this polynomial is called cubic polynomial. Okay, children. If degree of the polynomial is 4, it's called fourth degree polynomial. That means it has no fixed name. Only 0, 1, 2, 3. Its degree is 0, 1, 2, 3 have fixed names. Constant polynomial. If degree of the polynomial is 0, then it is constant polynomial. If degree of the polynomial is 1, then it is linear polynomial. If degree of the polynomial is 2, then it is quadratic polynomial. If degree of the polynomial is 3, then it is cubic polynomial. If degree of the polynomial is 4 or 5 or anything, it is called as 4th degree polynomial, 5th degree polynomial, like that. Usually, if degree of the polynomial is n, then it is called nth degree polynomial. Okay, children? Now, in the definition of polynomial, we have non-negative integers. That means 0 and positive integers 1, 2, 3. Here we got all the degrees 1, 2, 3. What about 0? Degree of the polynomial is 0. So then it is called constant polynomial. But we have a number 0. If a number is 0, then which type of polynomial it is? It is 0. It is 0, therefore it is a 0 polynomial. But what about degree of its 0 mean? 0 polynomials means it is undefined. Because 0 can be written as 0 into anything. We can't define the degree of it. It may be 0 into x power 1, 0 into x power 2, like that. Therefore, 0 means 0 of the 0 polynomial and its degree is undefined. Okay. Types of polynomials according to number of terms. In a polynomial, based on the number of terms, we will divide the polynomials. If number of terms are 1, then that polynomial is called monomial. You all know this, children. In your lower classes, you learnt all these things. Monomial. For example, it should have only one term. Whether it is 2x, 2y or 3y square, 4x cube, whatever it may be. Only one term we should have, then it is called monomial. If number of terms are 2, then it is called binomial. If number of terms are there, then it is called binomial. 2x plus 3y, 4y square minus 7, etc. Okay. If number of terms are 3, then it is called trinomial. Number of terms are 3, then it is called trinomial. X square plus y square plus z square, 2x cube plus 3x square minus 4x. No need of degree. Only number of terms we should consider here. So it has only 3 terms, x square, y square and z square. And this polynomial 2x cube, 3x square minus 4x. Only 3 terms we have, therefore it is called trinomial. In the name only there, tri, 3 terms, bi, 2 terms. Monomial, mono, 1 term. Okay, next. If there are more than 3 terms, more than 3 terms means it should have, it can have 4 or 5 or 6, whatever it may be, then it is called multinomial. More than 3 terms, if a polynomial have, then it is called multinomial. X square plus 2xy plus y square minus 4y, etc. Okay, children? These are types of polynomials according to number of terms. If a polynomial has only one term, then it is called monomial. If a polynomial has only 2 terms, then it is called binomial. If a polynomial has 3 terms, then it is called trinomial. If a polynomial has more than 3 terms, then it is called multinomial. So, types of polynomials according to degree and according to terms. According to degree means constant polynomial, linear polynomial, quadratic polynomial, cubic polynomial and nth degree polynomial. Okay, children? Okay, children, now polynomials in one variable. So, we have in some polynomials 2 variables or 3 variables. But polynomials one variable means we should have only one variable, whether it is x or y or z or r, whatever it may be. X, x square, 3x cube plus 4x square minus 5x, like that. Okay, children? Y cube, 3y cube minus 4y square plus 2y plus 7. How many variables in this polynomial? Only one variable, y. In these polynomials, x is a polynomial, x square is a polynomial and 3x cube plus 4x square minus 5x. So, how many variables? Only one variable. So, these are called polynomials in one variable. if it polynomial in x, it is, it can be denoted as p of x or q of x, r of x, g of x, z of x, like that. We can denote the variables. If the polynomial is in variable x, it is denoted as p of x, like that. Here, polynomial is in y variable. Therefore, it is denoted as p of y, q of y. Whatever any English alphabet you can write for polynomial, f of y, g of y. But generally, we use mostly p as it is polynomial. Okay, children? Okay, children, general form of variables. You know the types of variables according to degree. If degree is 1, then it is linear. Degree is 2, then it is quadratic. So, linear form, general form of linear polynomial. It is, how much will be the degree for linear polynomial? 1. So, ax plus b is the general form of linear polynomial, where a should not be equal to 0. What happens if a is equal to 0? If a is equal to 0, the x term will be 0. If there is no x term, here b is a constant. That means it is a constant polynomial, but it is not a linear polynomial. So, if it have to be linear polynomial, definitely it should be in the form of ax plus b. And here b may be 0 or may not be 0. For example, 2x is also a linear polynomial. 2x plus 4 is also a linear polynomial. But generally, it should be in the form like 2x plus 4 ax plus b. X is a variable and a comma b are constants, coefficient of variables. Okay, children? Now, general form of quadratic polynomial. General form of quadratic polynomial. Quadratic means, how much will be the degree? 2. Ax square plus bx plus c. Here also, coefficient of x square, a should not be equal to 0. Okay? Now, general form of cubic polynomial. What is the degree of cubic polynomial, children? It is 3. So, general form of cubic polynomial is ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d. And here also the coefficient of x cube, a should not be equal to 0. BCD may be 0. But for cubic polynomials, but generally it should be in the form of ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d. Next, if fourth degree polynomial, for fourth degree polynomial, ax power 4 plus bx cube plus cx square plus dx plus e. And here also, since it is a fourth degree, the coefficient of x power 4, a should not be equal to 0. Okay, children? Like that, what is the general form of nth degree polynomial? For nth degree polynomial, an x power n. A n minus 1 x power n minus 1 plus so on. A2 x power 2 plus a1 x power 1 plus a0 x power 0. X power 0 means anything power 0 is 1. So, x power 0 1 means it is a0. So, we can end this nth degree polynomial as a0 also. Here, a0, a1, a2, an minus 1, an all are constants and coefficients of variables. Okay? And here also, since it is a nth degree polynomial, the coefficient of x power n, an, should not be equal to 0. Okay, children? With all this, with this class, you can do your exercise 2.1. You can complete each and every problem in exercise 2.1. And also do this, try this, think and discuss in your textbook. Okay? Okay, children. Now we will see how to find the value of the polynomial. Find the value of the polynomial x square plus 5x plus 4. Yet x is equal to 0, 1 and minus 2. That means we have to find the value of this polynomial. That means instead of variable in the given polynomial, we have to substitute these values. First, let us say the given polynomial is p of x is equal to x square plus 5x plus 4. Now we have to find the value of this polynomial p of x at 0. First we will take at x is equal to 0. That means in the given polynomial, instead of variable x, we have to replace 0. At x is equal to 0, the value of the polynomial is p of 0. Polynomial is p of x. So at x is equal to 0, it is p of 0. That means in the given polynomial, the what is the variable? X. So instead of x, we have to write 0. X square, 0 square plus 5 into x in place of x, 0 plus 4. 0 square means 0 into 0. It is 0 plus 5 into 0, 0 plus 4. 0 plus 0 plus 4 is 4. So the value of polynomial p of x, x square plus 5x plus 4 at the value 0 is 4. Okay, children. Now we will find the value of this polynomial at x is equal to 1. Let p of x is equal to x square plus 5x plus 4. And we should find the value at x is equal to 1. That means we have to find p of 1. That means in the given polynomial, instead of variable x square plus 5 into x plus 4, we should replace this variable with 1. So 1 square plus 5 into 1 plus 4. 1 square, 1 into 1, 1 plus 5 into 1, 5 plus 4. So the value of this given polynomial p of x at x is equal to 1 is 10. Okay, children. Now we will find the value of minus 2. At minus 2, the value of given polynomial p of x is equal to x square plus 5x plus 4. We have to find at x is equal to minus 2. So in the given polynomial, in place of variable, we should replace it with minus 2. Minus 2 square plus 5 into minus 2 plus 4. Minus 2 square. How will you find? Minus 2 can be written 2 times and multiplied. So minus 2 into minus 2. Minus into minus plus 2 into 2, 4. Again, plus here it is minus. Plus into minus, minus. 5 to 10. Plus 4. 4 minus 10 plus 4. First we will add these two terms. 4 plus 4. 8 minus 10. What is the value of 8 minus 10? 8 is plus and 10 is minus. So we should subtract these two terms and we write the sign minus, because 10 is the bigger number in these two and 10 have the sign minus. So 8 minus 10 is minus 2. So the value of x square plus 5x plus 4 at minus 2 is minus 2. Okay, children, got it? Now find the value of the polynomial 4x square minus 5x plus 3 at x is equal to 1 by 2. So the given polynomial is 4x square minus 5x plus 3. We have to find the value. Yet x is equal to 1 by 2. That means in place of x, we have to replace it with 1 by 2. Now we will see the solution, children. Now write what is the given polynomial. Let the given polynomial be p of x is equal to 4x square minus 5x plus 3. We have to find this. Yet x is equal to 1 by 2. That means we have to find the value of p of 1 by 2. So what is the given polynomial? 4x square. So instead of x, we have to write 1 by 2 minus 5 into x. Instead of x, we have to write 1 by 2 plus 3. 4 into 1 by 2 square. If you can do directly, you can write. Otherwise, you can simplify this. 1 by 2 can be multiplied 2 times. So 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 minus 5 into 1 by 2. 5 1 ja 5 by 2 plus 3. So 2 1 ja 2 2 ja 4 in the numerator and 2 in the denominator. Again it is in denominator. 2 1 ja 2 2 ja. Otherwise children, you can do like this. What is the value here? 4 into 1 by 2 into 1 by 2. So 4 into 1 1 ja 1, 2 2 ja 4 minus 5 by 2 plus 3. So now this 4 in the numerator and 4 in the denominator getting cancelled. So 1 minus 5 by 2 plus 3. So first we add 1 plus 3. 1 plus 3, 4 minus 5 by 2. So now we have to subtract this. 4 can be written as 4 by 1 minus 5 by 2. So to subtract two fractions, we have to take LCM for the denominator. What is the LCM for 1 and 2? 2. So to get 2 here, how many times? 1 can be multiplied with 2 to get 2 times. 1, 2 ja 2. So 4 also can be multiplied with 2. So 2, 4 ja 8 minus 2 lo 2 into it is 1 times. So 2, 1 ja 2. So 5 can be multiplied with 1. So 5, 1 ja 5. 8 minus 5, 3 by 2. So, the value of p of x at x is equal to 1 by 2 is 3 by 2. Okay, 3. One more problem, children. Find the value of the polynomial x plus 2 at x is equal to 0, 1, 2 and minus 2. Okay, what is the given polynomial, children? The given polynomial p of x is equal to x plus 2. We have to find the value of p of 0. That means at x is equal to 0, we have to find p of x. At x is equal to 0, p of 0 is equal to, in the given polynomial, instead of variable x, we have to write 0. 0 plus 2, 2. So p of 0 is equal to 2. Next, at x is equal to 1. So that means we have to find p of 1. In the given polynomial, in place of variable, it is x plus 2. In place of x, we have to write 1. 1 plus 2, 3. Okay. Next, at x is equal to 2, we have to find p of 2. You all know what should be written, children, here? 2. 2 plus 2, 4. Okay. Now, at x is equal to minus 2, value of the given polynomial is p of minus 2. So in place of x, we have to write minus 2. So minus 2 plus 2, what will be the answer, children? 0. So in every at values x is equal to 0, we got the value 2. At x is equal to 1, we got the value 3. At x is equal to 2, we got the value 4. But at x is equal to minus 2, we got the value of the polynomial is 0. Therefore, this constant minus 2 is called 0 of the given polynomial. That means, at which value of x we will get the value of polynomial as 0, then that constant value of x is said to be 0 of the given polynomial. Here, at x is equal to 0, value is 2. So, 0 is not said to be 0 of the polynomial here. 1 is also not said to be 0 of the polynomial because we got the values as numbers. But at x is equal to minus 2, we got it as 0. Therefore, minus 2 is said to be 0 of the given polynomial x plus 2. Okay, children? In tomorrow's class, we clearly learnt about what is 0 and how to find the 0 of the given polynomials. Okay, children? In today's class, we learnt about what is polynomial, how to check whether it is a polynomial or not, degree of the polynomial, coefficients, types of polynomials according to degree and types of polynomials according to number of terms, and polynomials in one variable, general form of polynomials, and value of the polynomial and zero of the polynomial. Okay, children, in tomorrow's class, we will continue the class. Thank you, children. Thank you, one and all.